Digital Performer is a product of the Mark of the Unicorn Company, and I am in no way associated with Mark of the Unicorn.
Good afternoon. Today we're going to be discussing digital audio workstations. And digital audio workstations are for music production and film compositioning and composing for film and you name it. It's a very expressive tool. The tool that I use is Digital Performer, and that's what we'll be using in these videos. So let's get down to it.
Here's a screenshot of Digital Performer. In this screen right here, we have the mixer window for your console, for your audio files, your MIDI files, your auxiliary returns, your virtual instrument tracks, etc. Then you have a sequencer overview window here where you do a lot of your major copying and pasting. You can do it in the other window, but this you have more of a grand view of the whole sequence, of the whole project. So you can come here and say, okay, here's second verse. I want to repeat it. So, you just kind of highlight it, take it. Then go on down here and paste it. Done deal. Then you have your undo. Anyway, but then we have the main sequence window, sequence editor, where you get in here and you can trim audio files and edge sound bites and what have you. Then you have your audio editor. And that's pretty much about it. DP is a pretty extensive application. There's other windows. You have different window sets. You can have tracking window. It's set up different for this. Mixing window. It's just set up for mixing. I have custom window sets that I have set up here, so it's pretty much goes into the, my main default view for my sessions. And then I have my plug-in counts and everything set up within the, I have, when I go and open up a new template, I have my mastering templates, different types of presets. So that's pretty much a grand tour of DP. We could get a lot deeper into it, but that's for another video.